Texas. Chief Evans and the commander, Mike Benavides, B-E-N-A-V-I-D-E-S.
Harry Evans, Chief of Staff, Austin Fire Department.
Say your mic, Chief.
Well, we'll do so. I'll pass up. We'll just pass off the mic.
I can't even see that. Sorry.
Thank you.
Anybody else?
Right here to your right.
Okay. You can hold yours.
Yep,
right?
I can hold.
Is that it?
Hey, Julie. Go a little tighter.
Okay, good morning.
You're on the tripod.
Thanks. First of all, I want to thank everybody for your patience. It is this morning at about 12:30 a.m., a member of the Austin Police Department in a marked patrol unit working an overtime detail that we call STEP here in Texas. Looking for DWI drivers, people driving under the influence, initiated a traffic stop at the Shell gas station right up here on the southbound 35 frontage road at 9th Street, just around the corner down the street from here. That was about 12:30 a.m. The sole suspect driver of that vehicle, when the officer initiated the stop, turned on his turn signal, very calmly drove into that gas station. The gas station, as you can imagine, with all the activities around, was very busy. He's in a smaller vehicle. He was able to weave his way through some of the vehicles. He exited the gas station, made a right turn here on East 9th Street that you see behind you, and he accelerated at a high rate of speed down the street, going the wrong way on a one-way street. The officer in the back police car turned on all his lights and immediately tried to overtake the vehicle. The suspect vehicle then made a right turn. As you can see, this street is closed. This roadway is closed. We had an officer wearing an Austin police officer in uniform working barricade control. He was forced to move out of the way to avoid being struck himself. The suspect driver then accelerated at a high rate of speed down the street right here behind me, Red River Street, and at a high rate of speed struck multiple pedestrians. That had been on the street. The suspect continued at a high rate of speed down Red River and at striking multiple people, and I'll give you some numbers here in a minute. At 11th Street, which is two lights behind me, the suspect vehicle struck a moped with a male and female on the moped and also struck a taxi. He then crashed on the northwest corner into a parked van. The suspect then exited the vehicle and attempted to flee on foot. The officer was able to overtake him on foot and was actually forced to tase him to take him into custody. As a result of this person's reckless and willful disregard for the safety of the people of this city that were here on along Red River, we've had two individuals that were pronounced dead on the scene that were riding the moped, a male adult and a female adult. We also have an additional 23 victims. Out of those 23 victims, five are considered critical, and the rest are walking wounded to moderate. They have been transported to area hospitals, and the fire and EMS will talk about, as you can imagine, a very comprehensive response to the scene. This suspect will be charged by the Austin Police Department with two counts of capital murder. In the state of Texas, when you murder somebody in one event and it's two or more people, it is a capital offense, and we will be direct filing two counts of capital murder. We have contacted the district attorney's office to respond out here with one of their deputy prosecutors or the DA prosecutors, and he will also be charged with 23 counts of aggravated assault with a vehicle. That's all the information I have right now. I want to just say that